Hi everyone, welcome to the second video in this introductory series of Apollo Server and how you can host your GraphQL server in Azure. My name is Michael Watson, and in this video, we're going to take the project we had previously built, and we're going to see just how easy it is to host this in an Azure App Service using VS Code and the VS Code App Service extension. Now, in the project that we have, the first thing we'll need to do is get our Azure App Service extension and sign into our Azure account. It's a pretty straightforward process, and we should just be able to log in through our browser. All of our resources should load up, and now we can start deploying out our new server. The first thing we'll want to do is change the port that Apollo Server is listening to 8080, which is the default for an Azure App Service. After that, we'll just need to deploy to a new web app. I'm going to give it a name. We'll give it a new resource group. We're going to run it on Linux. And then we're going to set to the latest node runtime. Now we can monitor this deployment in the Integrated Terminals Output tab. Great. Now that our deployment's completed, our container's restarting right now, and it should have GraphQL Playground running any second. Now, we can just open the link and browse to the website, and you can see GraphQL Playground pops up right here. Now, what's awesome is since we already set up our debugging, we now have the capability of doing remote debugging. To remote debug our application, we'll just need to right-click the app service we want to debug and start a remote debugging session. This will tunnel a proxy and allow us to remote debug that application. So now we can just simply write out our query, and that'll go into our remote debugging session right in VS Code. This is one of the reasons why we want to set up debugging right from the start. So just to recap in today's video, we took the project that we had previously built, we hosted it into an Azure App Service using the VS Code extension, and we were able to set up remote debugging against that Azure App Service, which will help us build out our GraphQL server. Now that we've taken our basic GraphQL server and we've hosted it inside of an Azure App Service, along with testing out some of the remote debugging capabilities, in our next video, we're going to take this same project and we're going to host it in Azure Function. One of the things I love about Azure Functions is I think it's a great tool to use to create a small proof of concept to show internally and get buy-in on maybe a larger GraphQL project. One of the reasons for that is it's really easy to use, but also it has a very generous free tier. So stay tuned for the next video where we'll dive deeper into Azure Functions.